Breast cancer, as you know, is still the number one cancer killer of women all over the world. These days, unfortunately, it's happening in much younger women, and we really have got no answers as to why this is happening. Screening for breast cancer, therefore, is the only tool that we have, and we recommend it to all age-appropriate women. And although there has been yet a cure to be found for breast cancer, there has been tremendous improvement in the management of the disease. So early detection is probably the only hope we have for a potential cure. With early detection, minimally invasive procedures are possible, which include breast-conserving surgeries, sentinel node biopsies, and now the intraoperative radiotherapy. For women who require to undergo a mastectomy, immediate and delayed reconstructions are also possible. So what is intraoperative radiotherapy, you may ask? Well, here, when a woman has a lumpectomy, a single high-dose radiation is delivered to the tumor bed intraoperatively. Now, it is done by both the surgeon and the oncologist while the patient is under anesthesia. A specialized device is used by the surgeon, and this device is placed into the tumor bed once the lumpectomy has been done. The oncologist then comes in and delivers a single high-dose radiation to the tumor bed. And this high dose is equivalent to 5 weeks of external beam radiation. Now, the great advantage here is the duration of treatment that is cut short. From 5 weeks of radiation, we are able to deliver the exact dose in a single shot during surgery. Now, it's an excellent option for women, especially those who have to travel far regularly on a daily basis for external radiation, and as well as for those women who are coming from out of station. Now, in younger patients, or when unfortunately the lymph nodes are found to be positive postoperatively, the same treatment, the intraoperative radiotherapy, can be used as a boost, and the patient then has the balance of the radiation later as external beam. The great advantage of this treatment modality is the shortened treatment time, efficient dosing, and better sparing of the surrounding healthy tissues. Now, not all women are diagnosed early. For those women who are diagnosed with slightly larger tumors, breast-conserving surgery may not be possible, and these women will be recommended a mastectomy. However, when a mastectomy is recommended, oncoplastic surgery is also offered to these patients. And oncoplastic surgery basically just means reconstructive surgery associated with the cancer surgery. Now, oncoplastic breast surgery can be done as an immediate procedure or a delayed procedure. Now, patients are usually given all the options of the reconstructions, and they are usually advised what is the possible best option for them. And after a full discussion and full understanding of the pros and cons of all the procedures, the patient usually makes the decision. Now, reconstruction may involve using autologous tissue. That means using your own body tissues, your body fat, which can be transferred to give the volume in the reconstructed breast. Or implants can be used. These are cohesive gel implants, which are very safe these days. Now, these days, the skin and nipples of the patients are spared during surgery so that the reconstructed breast will resemble as close to the natural breast as possible. Now, it is important to understand, however, that a reconstructed breast is never the same as the original, whether in appearance or the feel of it. Now, so a realistic understanding of the procedure and what to expect is very, very important. Oncoplastic surgery, especially the immediate procedure, may prevent further surgeries in the future. So in many patients, oncoplastic surgery or reconstructive surgery aids in the patient's recovery, not only physically, but emotionally and psychologically as well. Now, the surgical management for breast cancer and breast disease has advanced tremendously over the years. So consult your doctor when you have a question. Now, the best management plan will be drawn out for you and tailored to your needs. But of course, it must be safe and effective.